We are going to introduce our new finding about the high efficiency triple illumination arc conversion deep blue OLEDs. I'm project leader Tianlong Chiu from the Yuanzhi University in Taoyuan, Taiwan. As we know, OLED marketing is growth in the future. No matter Chinese news, Japanese news, English news also say that the marketing is growth. And OLED has some advantage compared to LCD without the backlight. And OLED is a simple structure. And OLED can apply for the flexible, transparent electronics, and also has the fast response time, and also has the wide view angle, and could be the large area manufacturing. And OLED right now is applied for the cell phone and transparent TVs, hand mount display, and for the next generation Nintendo Switch display, and also apply for the lighting market. But OLED still has some concern. According to the UDC report, their phosphorescence OLED, they has a blue one has some issue in the lifetime because of the short lifetime. And also in the OLED display, the light spanning, blue OLED also have the only the 50,000 hours short lifetime. Our lab result and also say that after agent, the blue portion and become the decrease, and then we will see the burning. The blue material is damaged. So the blue OLED still has some problem in the efficiency and the lifetime. We will introduce about the basic OLED structure. We combine, we have the four layer. Anode, hole transporting layer, emitting layer, electron transporting layer, and the cathode. And then we apply the voltage on carrier will inject into the organic layer and transport to the interface, accumulate in the interface. And then minor cavity will inject and to form the acetone. And then the acetone will diffuse and release the energy, become the photon. OLED right now has the three generation. The first generation is fluorescence OLED. It has a low efficiency and reasonable lifetime. For the second generation is phosphor OLED, and then has the high efficiency, low lifetime for the red and the green. Also have the short lifetime for the blue, and use the heavy metal and leading the cost up. For the third generation TADF and Cypress, it has the high efficiency and without use the heavy metal, but still has some problem in the short lifetime for the blue. So the market go back to the 1.5 generation using the TTA OLED. It has a reasonable lifetime and also has a moderate efficiency. For the energy system, electroluminescence, we apply the electric inside and then the 100% acetone will form illumination. And 25% is singly and 75% is triply. And then the phosphorescence relative emission mechanism use the perfect IQE. And then the fluorescent emission mechanism that has the maybe below the 100% the IQE, especially for the long lifetime mechanism is the TTA and TTA-UC. They also only have a very low IQE compared to others. For the mechanism for the triple illuminations, we use the inside the singly acetone and then IC to the triple, and then energy to the emitter triple. Two triple will form one singly and then become the emissions. So in this mechanism, we have a long time the triple diffusion, and then go and become the one singly blue emissions. So how to improve this the efficiency? We can use the sensitizer improve and also emitter improve. And for the TTA mechanism, we can try use the PLO. We have the green laser and to excite, and then we can see the TTA blue emission as a video. Yeah, we have a strong blue emission from the listed PLO experiment. And we go into the fabricate our concept first generation TTA UC device. Yeah, we use the ALQ3 and ADN emitting layer. So we will make the carrier recombine in the first ALQ3 layer. And then the triple E energy will go to the ADN, transfer to the ADN, and then to process the TTA, become the delay blue emission. And we can also see this kind of delay blue emission in the TR yellow signal. But we still can see some the emission from the green, with from the LQ3 emissions. So this LQ3 is not, emission is not our expect. So we try to block this kind of energy back transfer. So we install a TDSB layer and to block the singly back energy transfer. And then we can rise in our blue efficiency. We can have a high efficiency. And then, so this kind of TDA-UC, we have some advantage about the low driving voltage and the better operation lifetime. So we have the three layer TTA-UC device, and we can see we have the green sensitizer and use a blocking layer, and also have the ADN emitter. When we optimize, we can see the EQE, the efficiency is the rising. And then the green emission will be suppressed, and we will see the no green emissions. And we use the first generation concept and replace some material and for the high POQY. And then we can fabricate the second generation deep blue TTA UC OLED. And then we will rise our EQE to the 50.5%. Yeah, right now this efficiency is a world record. So this the system also passed the WISE Semiconductor Corporation verification and to improve their product efficiency and lifetime. And we also patent the two USA patent and two Taiwan patent, and for this kind of TTA UC emission mechanism. Oh, this is my interesting field and my honors and award. And I already have the over 40 paper patents and 100 SCI paper and 200 conference paper. And in my lab, I have a thermal operator and the CS1000 and FN systems, and we can line on the device. And we also have the FN image TRELO systems, and then is the measurement system, error flow meter, and also have the PLO system. And we can fabricate a deep blue and sky blue, green and red in our lab. And our cooperation is Professor Liang Wenjie and Professor Wu Yizhen and Professor Junhao Li. They are in the NTU in Taiwan. Professor Liang Wenjie used response for the normal material synthesis and development. And Professor Wu Yizhen and they can develop a software to do the OLED simulation in a 2D or 3D. And Professor Junhao Li, they also can do the device fabrication, measurement, and analysis. Thank you for your attention.